Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. Today is a very exciting day because we finally get to show you the reveal of the sunroom. We've been working so hard on this space. It has taken us about a month and we're so excited to show you how it turned out. Talk a little bit about what the space was like before we made it over. So the space was kind of dark in here. There was black carpet throughout. There was actually a pool table as well as like a, what do you call those? Like a billiard light over the pool table.
Yeah, like a pool table light.
Mm-hmm. And someone had tried to whitewash the cedar at one point and it did not look very good.
Didn't look good at all. It just kind of drew out some of the flaws in the wood.
Yeah, and there was a lot of staining on the wood. We don't know if it was from like a previous leak or why there was staining. Thankfully, we have not seen signs of it since painting, and it's probably been, what, like 3 weeks?
3 weeks, and it's rained a ton, especially in the past couple of days.
We ended up giving the pool table away for free on Facebook Marketplace. That was kind of the first big challenge that we had because those pool tables are so heavy.
Yeah, and we knew before we could get started doing anything, that thing had to be out of here.
So we purchased a paint sprayer just to try to make it go a little bit quicker and got to doing that. And then we lifted up the carpets after we were completely done painting and got to work on the flooring. We did some DIY curtain rods in here. There are windows all around this room. And so we knew that we were going to need a lot of curtains in here and that would get really expensive if we needed to purchase rods and curtains for it. So we just used PVC pipe, spray painted it black, and then purchased just your basic curtain rod holders from Amazon. And it was a really inexpensive way to get curtains all around this room. And then it was time to kind of focus on the design of the room. And because of this cedar in here, it just kind of naturally had more of like a cottage feel. So we really wanted to kind of play into that a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and show the mood board here so you can see what kind of helped drive the design throughout. I think it's really important to kind of have a visual before beginning, and making up these mood boards, including photos of furniture that I knew was going to go in the space, as well as things that I wanted to purchase, and just seeing kind of how they all played together was really important in creating like a cohesive design. We knew that we wanted it to be we wanted to have that cottage feel to it. We wanted it to be whimsy. We wanted a lot of twinkly lights and just for it to feel
magical.
Magical. That's a good word. So, but of course I wanted to include my love of antiques and all of those like vintage finds. We really like to use thrifted and antiques in our design. Typically, we go for more of like a traditional feel. But back here, we really kind of got to step out of that and do something that had a little bit more of a connected to nature feel, if that makes sense.
Thank you.
there are still a few things that we want to do to this space that we haven't done yet, but we couldn't hold out any longer. We really wanted to finally reveal the room. We're about 95% done, I would say.
Yeah, we want to change out the storm door. It's kind of got a yellowy, dingy look to it, and we really just want it to be white and cohesive with the rest of the room. And it'll get done, and we're looking forward to that, probably sooner than later, just because we'll get tired of looking at it.
Yeah.
Same with the fan. The ceiling fan is still the original ceiling fan that was in here, and it kind of still has that whitewashed look to it, and it just kind of looks cheap and ugly. So we'll be looking to replace that as well. It's not going to have a light on the new one because we already have the twinkly lights up here in the space. So we're just gonna get just a ceiling fan. And I think that'll clean the look up. It'll be white as well and just have a clean look to it. It'll bring the whole room together.
The ceilings in this area are slightly vaulted, and it's just a really pretty feature and unique feature of this room. So we definitely don't wanna draw the eye down. We want your eye to go up. So we just want something that's super understated. White, we don't really need a light. I think it just keeps the cost down. We're always looking for budget-friendly options. So as far as decor goes, this seating area is feeling a little bit incomplete to us. We had a table that I had thrifted a while back that I sanded down and was going to paint and use in here. But once we put it in the space, it just felt a little bit too big. So we are going to potentially get some little like side tables, and I need to do some pillows and just a few things to really cozy up this area. We also, for the seating area, have ordered a projector. So it's just a little tiny one. I don't know, is it like a high quality one?
I think it's like $100 to $150 on Walmart. So it's not super high quality. It's got 1080p and it has the speaker built in. It looks nice. That was a huge part of why I got the one I got, because it's just gonna be kind of sitting out on a table.
Yeah, it has like a vintagey feel to it.
Yeah.
So we just wanted to have an option to maybe like put on a sports game.
A sports game, you know, so we can watch sports ball or maybe a movie.
Yeah, so we could watch movies or put a game on. And I'm not gonna watch the game, but you will, so there's
right.
That.
We're not going for a whole movie theater vibe in the area.
No.
Because it's not anything where you're gonna wanna sit here all day long and veg out and watch movies, but it'd be nice just to be able to put something up if we wanted to.
Yeah, so projector, we've got a perfect little spot for a projector screen that's kind of out of the way, so when it's put away, I don't think you're even going to notice it unless you knew it were there. So the only other thing that we had in mind when we initially came up with the design for this room was that we wanted to have a rug underneath the dining table as well. And at this point, we just haven't found the right one. So we may still add that later. I kind of like right now how you can see the floors, just because the floors have so much texture to them. But that might be something that we eventually add. And other than that, I think we're mostly done. We will definitely update you guys in a later video if and when we kind of get around to doing these things. Maybe we'll do like a little update towards fall and just show you guys like how the space has evolved since finishing it.
Yeah, we plan on getting a lot of use out of it this summer, so some things may change as far as what we keep in here functionality wise.
Yeah.
And thank you guys so much for watching. We worked really hard on the space. We're super proud of it. We spent a lot of time and a lot of money, right?
Yeah.
but we really do enjoy the space, and we appreciate you watching.
If you guys missed it, we have a whole playlist of videos for this makeover, so you can actually see the in-depth process of some of the steps that we took. We always try to do budget friendly, so if you are needing ideas on how you can make over a space on a budget, definitely check out those videos. I'll be sure to link that in the description box for you so you can check those out if you haven't already.
We plan on making a video that really breaks down the what we did well and what we would do differently. It'll be an in-depth video where we're sitting down talking to you about each little piece and how we did it and what we didn't like about it and what we maybe spent too much money trying to do.
Yeah. So make sure that you're subscribed so that you don't miss it, and we will see you in the next one.